The Great Lakes, the world's largest freshwater system. 20% of the world's fresh surface water, visible from space. Superior, Michigan, Huron, Erie, and Ontario. More than 35 million people drink from them. Thousands of species thrive in their habitats, and they are vital to industry and transportation in the Great Lakes region. After more than a century of use and abuse, scientists realized the lakes were in trouble. Industrial, farm, and city runoff and habitat destruction threatened their environmental, recreational, and economic value. In the 1970s, the U.S. and Canada got together to create the Great Lakes Water Quality Agreement to protect and restore the five Great Lakes. In 1987, the agreement identified 43 Great Lakes rivers and harbors with the most severe problems. We call them Areas of Concern, or AOCs. In these AOCs, scientists identified 14 key issues, including toxins in fish and wildlife that affect their health and make them dangerous to eat, damaged habitat, toxic sediment that prevents dredging, limiting recreation and shipping. We call these problems beneficial use impairments, or BUIs. The U.S. and Canada began addressing these problems right away, but funding was limited and progress was slow. That changed in 2010 with the Federal Great Lakes Restoration Initiative. The GLRI has provided over $2.2 billion for Great Lakes projects, including more than $700 million for AOC restoration. Each AOC has its own plan for rehabilitation, but cleaning up contamination is always an important first step. We carefully locate, remove, enclose, or treat contaminated sediment. Once the cleanup is complete, we can turn our attention to habitat restoration, which brings back environmental, recreational, and economic value. But how much is enough? How do we know when we're done? Scientists gather data throughout the cleanup and restoration work to monitor progress. State environmental agencies, US EPA, and local stakeholders evaluate the data. If the improvement is acceptable, BUIs are removed one by one from the AOC's list of problems. Once all BUIs are removed, we delist the AOC. But now what? An area may be brought up to snuff, but still not be all that it can be. So, now the community can continue to shape and enhance nature's design through funds from private, local, state, and federal partners. Boat and kayak launches, boardwalks, parks, and trails can add even more value to these recovering AOCs. Working together, we can make these former areas of concern areas to be proud of. So jump in and get involved. Visit this website to learn more about AOCs in your state and how you can get involved.